if we were out in the field in a, you know, nicer site with older trees, you know, again, we would probably, you know, look for our, you know, our oldest, say 20 trees. And if we were, this is kind of the difference between different applications of dendrochronology. If we were trying to get tree ages, if we were trying to understand the history of this stand, when, exactly when the trees germinated and established, where would we want to core the tree? At the very base. As you know, a tree, you know, a campus tree might only take, you know, 5 or 10 years to get to here, but on the kinds of sites that we go to, 20 years, 40 years to get to the site. And we're not as interested in the juvenile growth because it tends to not be as sensitive to climate. And part of the reason, if you remember that priority, where to allocate the growth, young trees are still growing height growth pretty fast. They need to grow diameter-wise to keep up. So the diameter growth, the ring widths, tend not to be quite as sensitive in a tree that's, say, less than 50 years old than older than that. So we'll just generally core wherever we have good access to the tree below the crown and where it's comfortable, which is usually waist height.
Exposure.
Yeah, great question. What I didn't say is that typically we will take two cores per tree and take them from opposite sides of the tree to kind of average out the width. There is some within tree variability. And in some cases, like if 2002 is absent on one side of the tree, it may be present but a micro ring on the other side. So it always helps to have two. If this tree were on a slope, a steep slope, I would take the two cores across the slope to avoid the reaction wood, which on a conifer would be on this side. Put more growth on this side, is that right? No, it's this side, right? All right, so the tricky part with starting the core is pressing in hard enough to get it to bite in the bark and then the outermost wood, and at the same time keeping the tip from wandering so you don't end up with a corkscrew core at the end. So it does take a little pressure. I'll just aim it into a bark crevice. And another difficult thing that we don't worry so much in this line of work, getting climate records, but is hitting the center of the tree or as close as possible. Again, if we were trying to get germination dates, we would be poking it, you know, right down here as close as we could to the bottom, really be aiming for center. If we didn't get center, we'd keep taking cores until we got very close to it. Here, you know, good enough. You know, we're gonna lose some data if we don't get the center, but maybe we can pick it up on the other core from the other side of the tree. All right, be very quiet. Hear that little knock? That means you've got good solid wood. So any conifer will give you that little knock. And that's just that the tree, especially the sapwood, remember it's still wet. You know, the moisture content is not as high now as it will be in a month or so. It probably has not started growing yet. Maybe this year it has. But that knock tells you you've got solid wood that's grabbing it when the borer stops. Okay, so the cutting bit is a little narrower in diameter than the rest of the borer. All right, so there's a little space in between the core that's been cut out and the inside of the bit, all right? But it's still attached, okay, at the end. So if I slide this in, I'm not gonna be able to just pull it right out. So what I need to do is slide it in, and here I'm gonna get some resistance as I get to the end of the core, where the bark is. It slides underneath. I'm not gonna be able to push it all the way in, the solid tree, because the tip of the extractor and the core and the bit are kind of meeting in a three-way junction, and it just stops. Now I want to back it off one turn, one full turn. This will break now, is that the extractor is, you know, wedged up against the core. So when I turned it back like that, the core, the end of the core breaks off from the tree. So it's now separated from the tree. And I should be able to pull it out. And the reason I go one full turn is so that the core is still in the same orientation that it was in the tree. So the tracheids should be running, the vessels should be running straight up and down. And so if I wanted to get the center of the tree, I know where the offset is. So we can see it's still kind of jammed at the end, and for whatever reason, I wasn't able to fully grab it with the spoon. But this is why you eat out at Chinese or Thai restaurants. Can I have someone hold that just in that position? Watch the tip, very, very sharp. And grab the highly sophisticated core removal tool. Try not to slice the fingers.
Anybody have a lighter?
There we go.
You could fan the metal.
There we go. So I was quite a ways off the pith. You could see it was, you could see the rings are starting to bend to the, yeah, the center would have been well off, you know, at least an inch and a half off to your right. And we can see this is not a very old tree. Surprise, surprise. Maybe 40 years old, even if we account for the time. But yeah, and it's it must have been, I wonder if they were watering this separately. Usually, you know, nearly all of the campus trees are getting some water from sprinklers, but it doesn't look like these did. Maybe that's why it's not doing so well. This might have been on a larger island in the past and had some vegetation that was being watered, possibly. Are we going to learn much about climate with this guy? Maybe. If he's not watered, it should show some of the ups and downs of climate of the last years, but if it's getting supplemental water, who knows? They could give us more. Let's see the outer. Let's see if we can put this back together. Ta-da! I was trying to see if we could find 2002 in there. And so if that's 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Might have broken right at 2002. We've got some very narrow rings in the 90s, which doesn't make much sense. Well, I guess 94 and 96 were dry, but again, this is not the tree we would core to get a good climate record, but it works for these purposes. Yeah, right.
Or maybe it was,
yeah, I mean, well, and you know, when did those limbs get cut and why, and
yeah.
I mean, the root system is obviously impinged by this asphalt, so, but that's how we would do it. And then I would store it in this other, this incredibly sophisticated core storage device. Paper straws. Why wouldn't I put it in plastic? Moisture will get moldy. Yeah, it's hard to get these too. I get them from Art Straws UK. Boxes of 900.
Wow.
Probably every dendrochronologist in the world is going to that same company. And they're like, why are we sending these to universities? These are for kids, right? And then, you know, after, it just takes a day or two for them to dry out in this climate. And then I can mount them and sand and could have this worked up within a few days. But probably won't. All right, well, thank you again
for
joining me today. Thank you.